I'm Govinda Kutty Dardan, Executive Vice President of NextTurn FinServ, Bangalore. If you look back 2 years, the way NBFCs have been growing, the business proportion that NBFC contributes to the economy was almost 20-25% of the entire credit flow in the market. And believe me, there were almost 12,000 NBFCs. But if you look at the numbers, actual numbers, out of the 12,000 NBFCs, almost 2,000 to 3,000 have been shut down because they could not meet the basic criteria, there were deviations in process. So RBI took an action to weed out these NBFCs, and as of now, we have close to 9,700 NBFCs in India, operating in India, of which less than 300, to be specific, 263 is the number, which are called strategically important, systematically important NBFCs, I would say. And there are, I think, 88 NBFCs which are deposit taking. So 263 plus 88, close to around 350 NBFCs are significant out of the 9,700. So what I mean to say is that 95% of the NBFCs are there in India are insignificant. So we are talking about 350 NBFCs contributing to this bulk volume of 25% of the total credit outflow. There were 2 to 3 key areas where NBFCs literally failed. One, the business was booming and everybody was running after that. So ultimately, when a business booms, you tend to lose control of the business. So ultimately, when the volumes are big and you are more eager to do more business, earn more money, the control literally loses its end. So what happened in NBFC, basically, from a strong business point of view to what NBFCs are today, is basically because of two reasons. One, there's something called an asset liability mismatch. That is, I need to ensure that whatever money I borrow from the market needs to be repaid on the due date. So what happened to the NBFCs, basically, starting from IL&FS to DHFL to Reliance or anybody for that matter, what has happened is that you get quick money, short-term money, and you lend this money for a long-term activity, basically into infrastructure, build-up, housing sector, which is long-term. Now, when the liability that you have borrowed, the money that you have borrowed is due for payment, what happens is that you don't have literally money coming back from the area where you have lent it. So the mismatch in tenure of the money that you borrowed and the money that you lent has landed the NBFCs in serious crisis of repayment of the obligations, which actually has created this problem. When the volumes were literally increasing, people were literally not looking at the quality of the lending. So these two things, the due diligence, the risk management on the borrower, was not done properly, and a big chunk of the portfolio ended up in delinquency, or what is called, we call the NPA. So this basically is the crisis. And NBFCs are going to emerge stronger, but everybody will not emerge. It is the survival of the fittest. The person, the company who has the best of systems, procedures, back-end support, capital, will definitely continue to flourish. Others will slowly fade away. We all hear about fintechs, and fintech is nothing but finance with technology. That is where technology has literally disrupted the financial lending. So here what happens is, at the back end, the decisions are taken based on certain parameters fed into the system, and the advantage for the lender is, if I do, as a human being, if I take judgment on 10 cases, no, I may have variations because it's a human mind. It depends on my mood, it depends on the timing, everything. But when it is technology, there is no bias, there's no partiality, there's no deviation. Every decision is perfect as per the parameters that is led into the system. So that is the advantage of fintech. Second is the time saving. Third is the documentation. Fourth is your MIS. So everything is available at a fingertip. So in real time, things happen and you are stable, your systems are working fine, everything goes very, very smoothly. Now, there are two things to this. Most of the fintech companies depend 100% on the technology. So the end-to-end decisioning, everything is on technology. But there are certain NBFCs who depend on the front end good set of loan origination system, which is the front end with good technology, artificial intelligence, data capture, data analysis, everything is there. But at the back end, still a human being looks at, okay, everything done by the system is okay, good to go. So that I feel is the best form of utilizing this technology. Now, if you look at what fintech companies do, basically, as I said, the inputs that's given by the applicant, it's processed in real time and a decision is taken. Now, there are areas where human behavior is analyzed through AI from different data sources that is available across, whether it is social media, whether it is his mobile apps, with anything that he does. For example, daily, which route do I take? Where do I go? Who are the contacts in my mobile? What messages do I get? For example, I'll tell you a small example. Now, the customer, if somebody applies to Needstone FinServ, we will ask him his bank details, his existing loan details, his EMI details. He will provide every document. Now, there are technologies that we use also to get some additional information. That actually, when he downloads the app, you know, that will actually land in his mobile and search what sort of messages are. Is there any message from any other bank? Okay, your EMI is credited, your loan is disbursed, your transaction so and so. That actually gives us additional information about the customer. There are social media angles, social media activities. I don't say social media activities are directly linked to a borrower's habits, but still you can evolve, you can get some additional input on human behavior, on how his spends are, how his contacts are. So we are in the process of implementing these additional inputs to our decision making, which will make it stronger. And we are sure as and when the technology evolves further, we will definitely make use of that in future also to ensure that we offer the best products in the best time to the best customer.